Hello, and welcome to this video on creating pie charts and doughnut charts in Google Sheets. As with many data visualizations, there are plenty of software options available to create these kinds of diagrams, but today we're going to be using Google Sheets. Before we get into making these though, let's have a glance at what we're looking to make. These are just very basic sketches with a lot of potential variations and applications. On the left, we have a pie chart, which looks like a pie or a pizza, which is divided into slices. Then on the right, we have a doughnut chart, which looks like a donut or a ring, which is also cut into sections. Essentially, these show the same thing, and in this case, they're divided up the same way as well. They take up the same amount of space too. In some chart variations, you can decide which is best depending on the amount of space you have, but here it's just preference. Visually, there's a little less going on in the donut chart as the donut is missing, which is why some people prefer them to pie charts. But let's go make a few, both pie and donut charts, and you can decide for yourself which you prefer. So we have some data to make our pie and donut charts out of. Our data is on game releases for the Sega Master System, which is a retro console that came out before the Sega Genesis. There were a few regions that the games were released in: Brazil, Europe, Japan, and the United States. And we're going to be making a chart for each so it shows the ratio or percentages of region-exclusive games, so those that only came out in that region, and compare it to the number of games that came out in that region and also came out somewhere else, so therefore not exclusive. There's quite a difference between the total number of games released in each region. You can see that Brazil and Europe had over 200 games released, Japan had only 80 or so, and the United States only had about 100. So that's quite a big difference, which is why making them into pie charts is going to make comparison a lot easier. Okay, so let's start by just highlighting these four cells, the title of the data, and then the two data points that we have for Brazil. I'm going to go up to the Insert menu and go to Chart. Okay, so Google Sheets sometimes tries to guess which chart type would work better for your data, and it gave us a line chart, which is not what we want. So we're going to change it over here at the side. I'm just going to click the drop-down menu, and it's got a pie chart right here. That's the one that we want. Okay, so that's better. Since we're going to be making a few of these graphs, though, we want to put a title on the chart. And to do that, if we go over to Customize, right now it's on Setup, click Customize. Then we have Chart and Access Titles. Okay, so let's add the text. Okay, that looks good, so let's close the Chart and Access Titles. Okay, so let's click on the pie chart option under Customize, and we can see that we have the percentage size for the donut hole. So we were making a pie chart, but we can actually just turn it into a donut chart by adjusting this percentage. We don't even need to change the type of chart. So let's try 25% and maybe 50%. That looks better. Okay, so we can also change the color of the slices if we click on Pie Slice under the Customize menu. So right now we're editing the region exclusive color. So right now it's blue. We can change it so that it's a green color. Click on this drop-down menu and not region exclusive. Okay, let's change that to a blue. Okay, that looks pretty good. Let's make it a little bit smaller and move it up to the corner here so that we have room for our other ones. Okay, so we have a couple more charts to make, and since we already formatted the Brazil one the way we want to, a really easy way to do that is to just copy and paste it again, and then we'll change the data. So we'll do Control-C and Control-V. We'll move it up next to the other one, and if we double-click on it, then we'll get the chart editor open at the side. And under the Setup tab of the chart editor, the labels are actually going to be the same because we have the region exclusive and the not region exclusive titles again. So we don't need to change that, but we do need to change the values because right now it's B2 and B3, which are the ones for Brazil. So if we click on that and click Select a Data Range, then instead of B2 and B3, delete those. We want B7 and B8. So we'll click OK, and that updates the graph for us. So let's also change the title so we don't forget which one this is. We'll just double click on it, and we'll change it from Brazil to Europe. Okay, so I'll just do that quickly for Japan and the United States, and then we'll have the full set of graphs. Okay, so now we have our complete set of four donut charts for each of the different regions, which means that we can easily compare the region exclusives to the not region exclusives. So as we saw, it's really easy in Google Sheets to change a pie chart into a donut chart and vice versa. Okay, so give me just a second and we'll change them from donut charts back into pie charts so that we can see the complete set of those just for comparison. Okay, so now they're all pie charts again, which is what we started off making. You can choose whichever you prefer, pie or donut. Okay, so that wraps up this video. We've covered the basics on creating pie and donut charts in Google Sheets. The version of Sheets you're using might mean that some of the features I showed are in different places or aren't available, but hopefully things should be roughly the same. The Google support website is really useful for learning how to do things, including making graphs and using formulas. But please reach out to the library too if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.